Meanwhile, the cops that actually did the right thing in Idaho and possibly stopped mass violence from happening at a pride event, they're getting death threats. The Idaho officers are now getting death threats after arresting 31 Patriot Front white nationalists near a pride event. We have video now from NBC News.
A U-Haul full of dudes.
A swarm of
a U-Haul full of dudes
came to riot. 31 suspected white nationalists zip-tied and arrested blocks from a pride festival.
These people want violence for us, and we don't want violence for anybody.
There was at least one smoke grenade. There was multiple shields.
Coeur d'Alene police Saturday discovered the crowd crammed in a U-Haul after a 911 caller described seeing a little army at a local hotel with masks on their faces and slogans like Reclaim America on their shirts. Police charging all 31 with conspiracy to riot, noting they planned to swarm several parts of Coeur d'Alene and carried paperwork similar to an operations plan that a police or military group would put together. They traveled in from states all across the country, allegedly united.
They're playing militia.
They appeared to be affiliated with the group Patriot Front.
Who is Patriot Front?
Patriot Front is a white supremacist group. It is anti-Semitic, racist, and homophobic to the core.
Experts say the group formed following 2017's deadly Unite the Right rally in Charlottesville, Virginia. Tonight, police in Idaho working with the FBI. Why Coeur d'Alene, Idaho?
White supremacist movement has deep roots in Idaho. And sometimes they'll choose small towns. Less security, easy to show up, less resistance.
Amid Pride Month, events across the country now on edge, knowing one small town may have dodged a violent confrontation. Maggie Vespa, NBC News.
Well, that's not the only confrontation. We had the Proud Boys.
Today, gas hit a new high.
Gas hitting a new high. We had the Proud Boys in California. Try to get in the face of some drag queens at a story time. Meanwhile, over on Fox, Pete Hegseth makes an infuriating comment on the hate group's arrest near a Pride parade. Here is the video. Posted by Media Matters.
More than two dozen men have been accused of belonging to a white nationalist group and are arrested near a pride parade in Idaho.
And police are saying the men piled into a U-Haul and planned to stage a riot.
It's interesting to see what comes.
I was trying to make it full screen.
Investigation. Ashley Strohmeyer is here with the details. Ashley.
Yeah, dozens of people in masks suspected of being tied to a white nationalist group were arrested near an Idaho Pride event yesterday, accused of conspiring to start a riot. Police in Coeur d'Alene confirming those people.
You're right, Sassy. Boys like to play dress up, so I don't understand why they don't understand drag queens and shit. It's same fucking deal. Same fucking deal. You guys want to play army.
People came to the event from multiple states and were found in the back of a rental truck.
31 people were detained. They were all wearing similar attire. They had shields, shin guards, and other riot gear with them. At this point, they appeared to be affiliated with the group Patriot Front.
So police say all 31 people are being charged with conspiracy to riot. One man's hat said victory or death. Another's shirt read Reclaim America. Many of the men reportedly wore patches identifying them with the Patriot Front group.
Where my country gone?
Also reporting police recovered at least one smoke grenade and an operations plan for the event inside that truck. The police chief says the intentions of the men were clear to start a riot. And then video later circulating of the men kneeling on the grass with their hands zip tied behind their backs and being escorted away by police. Police say they learned.
Look who's taking a knee now.
Tipster who reported the men loading into the truck in the parking lot of a hotel.
Her name is Ashley Strohmeyer.
Police say they learned about the U-Haul from a.
Name is Ashley Strohmeyer. Wild. It's apparently it was like a maid at a hotel that saw them all piling into the U-Haul together. Like it's a clown car. And that's how they got caught, because the maid called 911. That's hilarious.
Tipster who reported the men loading into the truck in the parking lot of a hotel. Back to you guys.
Okay, thank you, Ashley.
Yes. I just want to know how many BLM riots were prevented because we got in on the inside before they...
Wow, how many BLM riots? Let's change the subject completely. Let's do some whataboutism. Sir Hegseth, however the fuck you say your name, I would hate to tell you. No, I don't hate to tell you at all. I don't hate to tell you at all. Most of the violence during the summer of 2020 that you're calling BLM riots actually came from right-wing groups. Like this one. Feds say far-right group coordinated attack on Minneapolis police precinct during protest. The FBI brought charges against a member of the far-right Boogaloo Boys, participating in an effort to incite a riot outside a Minneapolis police precinct in May amid protests against the police killing of George Floyd. That's the one when they say that, when they say cities burnt down, that's what they're talking about. The Minneapolis Police Department. You can pretty much go city by city and all the major violent events during the BLM protests were actually right-wing organizations trying to make it look like the BLM protests were violent. I'm sorry. That's just the facts of the matter. Now, were there some BLM protests that got out of hand? Sure. I'm sure there were. But for fuck's sake, learn what you're talking about. And I had a dude one time tell me, it was like, well, the DOJ is corrupt. You can't listen to what they say. They indicted the Boogaloo Boys. Huh. I don't believe it. I'm like, well, sir, if you have a problem with the DOJ, wait till you find out what BLM was protesting. You dumb fucks. You dumb fucks. Idiots. Each and every one of you. Right-wingers are morons.